I'm Chuey Martinez, movie fanatic, and this is Erich Allman, combat medic, EMT, and DMT with 20 years of experience. Join us and our team of weapon experts as we analyze the demonstrations of the world's most lethal items from El Rey's Man-at-Arms Art of War, hosted by Danny Trejo. Right here on History's Deadliest Weapons. Which weapon is the deadliest? Let's learn a little history about the Yari.
The Yari was the primary weapon of the samurai. It dates to an even earlier time than the famous katana. Its primary use was to create a distance between the user and the opponent. In the right hands, the Yari is one of the deadliest weapons of medieval Japan. Yari is a spear blade intended for thrusting. The shape of the yari is similar to the Western bayonet. Triangular cross-section on the weapon creates wounds that are so damaging, they're very hard to heal.
There's two sharp peaked bevels on this side and a completely flat surface on the back.
Some armies have outlawed the use of bayonets specifically because the wounds were so cruel, they were inhumane.
Hey, Robert!
Hey, people!
What's up, Rebel?
Rebel got into making swords and knives. As a father seeing your kid learning techniques that are going to be lost if they're not learned and carried on, I think it's awesome.
To move steel and create it a usable work of art is truly an honor.
Rebel, what do you know about this?
The Japanese created a whole martial art called sojutsu, and it's nothing but spear fighting.
All right, Erich, now we're reviewing a weapon from Japan called the Yari. What are your first thoughts?
That blade is very long. It's very sharp, double-edged, thin, go through the space between the bones.
Yes.
Hit vital organs, and go right through you.
So we're ready to slice and dice, brother.
Let's get it done.
This is a real Yari.
Yeah.
Do it.
Yeah.
Okay, that brother right there knows what he's doing.
Yes.
So let's see how this Yari stacks up against this samurai armor.
Samurai armor is incredibly intricate and tightly woven. It makes it very hard for any weapon, especially cutting weapons, to get through to it. However, the Yari was really good at hitting the weak spots, such as the armpits right there, the midsection, and also right under the helmet.
Might be a spot between the breastplates there if you come at an angle. If you have that long reach, you could probably get your armor.
Getting ready.
That would have taken out your ligaments, whole rotator cuff.
Ooh!
Oh, yep. There it goes. That was a nice hit.
This weapon is mainly for hitting the weak spots. Hit the face, hit the shoulder, hit in the midsection.
I think it's interesting to see just how strong that armor is.
I like that.
That was pretty good.
That was fun.
Right shoulder. That's gonna rip your tendons, your ligaments. It's not gonna death kill, but you're gonna lose use of your arm. Now, the gut shot right
there. Yeah.
That's gonna go through the intestines. You could live.
So if you puncture an intestine, you might be okay?
Yeah, the armor's so far done a good job, except for the one where you hit in the face.
That's awesome.
Dead.
All right, Erich, so let's give our final thoughts on the Yari.
Not only does it keep the good distance, but the blade's very sharp, very long, thin. It's doing massive amount of damage. That's an impressive weapon.
Yes, it is. Is it a stealth killer or a shell filler?
Definitely, I'm gonna have to go stealth killer on this one.
Stealth killer. Me too, brother. Yes, high five. Good times. Thank you so much, man. That was a lot of fun. Hey guys, I'm your host, Chuey Martinez, and make sure to check out more videos from Man-at-Arms, Art of War, and History's Deadliest Weapons on the right, and hit the subscribe button on the left.